Gentleman from New Jersey.
Mr. Chairman, I yield 2 minutes to the chairman of the Transportation HUD Subcommittee, Mr. Diaz-Balart from Florida.
Gentleman from Florida is recognized for 2 minutes.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, I want to first thank the chairman for, again, bringing the 12 bills once again through their process. This is just a short-term continuing resolution. It's a clean date extension, and this CR will give an opportunity to continue to move forward quickly, by the way, towards finalizing appropriations bills. It's important to note that, for example, in the Transportation HUD bill, we considered 22 amendments in committee, 39 amendments here on the floor. You see, this has been an open and fair process the entire way. But now we must move quickly to finish the job and conference all 12 of these bills. In the meantime, however, we must keep the government open and funded. This is especially, by the way, important now that our communities are pulling together to recover from 3 devastating hurricanes, as well as the thousands of families threatened by raging wildfires in California. Look, we can't take the risk of shortchanging our first responders, our military, given the natural disasters at home and the threats from our adversaries abroad. A vote against this CR would do just that. So again, just for the transportation and housing segment, this CR will support ongoing transportation and safety missions, air traffic control, housing for vulnerable citizens, including our veterans. I strongly urge a yes vote on the CR. We cannot let those folks down. We cannot shut the federal government, and it allows us to finish the job, and I thank the chairman for his steadfast leadership. I yield back.